life of sin in this world I'm living in. I have done forbidden things I shouldn't do.
Welcome, dear brothers and sisters, in this session. I am Brother Daniel McAleish from Mozambique, training Kenya in marriage in Tanzania. Let us have a word of prayer and we'll continue the next day. Please be there with us and see more. Our dear Father in heaven, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we come before you this time. We invite your presence in this sermon. We ask for the Holy Spirit to guide every spoken word to come from the heavenly court and touch every ear, that whatsoever word will be spoken, bear fruits and repentance, and prepare souls to meet you soon in the clouds. This is my humble prayer in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Before we come to our sermon, I want to sing with you just one stanza of the Psalm 173 in our hymn book, International Hymns. This bears topic of sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer is interesting and always is very attractive.
Sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer, the cold is near from a world of care, and give me a
whereby we lay all our doubts, our burdens, our problems to our Heavenly Father, who never slumbers, always listens to petitions of His children. Today we can talk about four things which seem to be very small and interesting before our eyes, but which are exceedingly wise. Proverbs chapter 8. We're going to read the verses of 24, 25, 26, 27, and 28. Proverbs chapter 8. Please take your Bible in your language and let us read together this chapter in your language so that you can understand better if in case you don't have an English Bible together with you. In Proverbs chapter 8, verse 24, the Bible says, there be four things which are little upon the earth. They are little upon the planet earth, but they are exceedingly wise. The four things. The Bible is talking about beasts, animals. Four things small in our eyes or on earth when we behold them. Not small before the Lord. But in our eyes, they seem small and interesting. But the wise man Solomon says they are so exceedingly wise. Number one, on verse 25, the Bible says, the arms are a people not strong. The ants, the small insects which creep over the soil, which creep on the ground, the small animals, small people, and people are strong, yet they prepare their meat in the summer. Oh, what an interesting thing. They are people not strong, as we know. Even you can kill them by the fingers. Just mixing the two fingers, they can lose their lives, unlike us. That it needs a big struggle for someone to remove our lives. But an ant, even by just stepping on them, they can die. A people not strong. But they are wise in something which may be extraordinary, powerful than human beings. What do? They gather their meat, their food in times where food is found. But what Abu says, which shows that really this verse is very true. The Bible says on Acts chapter 8, verse 10, 11, the Bible says, "Behold, I will send anger, that is the Lord saying, and thirst, not a hunger of food, nor a thirst of water, but of the word of God. The people of different classes, president, ministers, poor people, students, singers, artists, and more others, they will run to and fro, east to west, south to east, to west to north, all the corners of the earth, trying to get the word of the Lord, but the Bible says, they will not find. The angels answered, they will never find the word of God, because they despise the word of God day and night. They gave heed to their own businesses, to their own life activities. They had no time to look for the Lord. They had no time to search the Lord when he can be found. They didn't have time to call upon him when he can answer them. They were busy to find their own pleasures and the things they lacked of this life. So the angel said, let the hungry continue being hungry. Why? Because they despised meal in time of summer. So late in times where food is no more found, continue being hungry. Brothers and sisters, when we see the ants, bees taking their meals to hide in their holes, we just think that it's their nature. We don't care. We don't even have time to start them. But it's a great lesson to us. The Bible says, the way today we hear, one day will no more be heard to us. The wise person, like an ant, is to take the word and keeps in his heart. That the time the word is no more found, he can have somewhere to eat. Because he kept in time where the word was available. Let us come to the next class. The Bible says on verse 26 about the next animals, which are very small before us, corns, whereby we're going to see on verse 26, the corns are but a fig fork, yet make their houses in the rocks. Just pray. They're very small animals, like the ants are very small, or very weak. Now we could wonder, are the ants people? But that is what someone says. People not strong. So people is not only human beings, but a group of some things, some living beings. So they're saying the corns also, they're very small or not strong animals, feeble animals. But they can manage to have their houses in their homes. What interesting. How about you and me, which have power, which have technology, which have got a lot of studies and wisdom? How could we fail to build our houses in the rocks? Jesus Christ once gave an example of two people who built their houses, one on the rock, another one on the sand. And there came a rain, and on the rock side, it was beaten by the rain and by the wind, and the houses stood strong. And the same rain came to the one building upon the sand, and the house is not stay. It was taken. It was destroyed completely. And Jesus didn't just stop there, but saying, still more work. And the loss of it was greater. Brothers and sisters, Jesus is so loving. He didn't give us just parables or proverbs without interpretation. He didn't give us prophets. He does nothing without telling his people his prophets. Jesus explained this parable. The people who build on the rock are those who hear my word and put it into practices. Because they can manage to build their houses in the rocks. How about you and me? The Bible says to build your house on the rock is to hear the word and put it into practice. And the rock is Jesus himself. But just see, the cool is they can manage to build their houses in the rocks. But we people, even stop seeing the temperature, the seeing that the weather itself, it is not favorable. End time, the tempest, the heavy rain can come, and our place is not safe. Still, we are not shaken to find a safe place. We see diseases, pandemics, and other things coming out in the earth to warn us that, brother, your house upon the rock. My sister, is your house upon a stable place? Please, it's time to wake up and try to find a rock and build your house in a stable place. Whether even the rain and all other circumstances may come to blow upon it, it may still stay. We see a lot of signs, God warning us to investigate our souls if our houses are built upon the rock. And this rock is Jesus. What is it? To hear the word of God and to put in practice. It's time now to investigate your soul. How? Search. If whatsoever you have heard, the truth you have received, you have set it into practice. You have put it in practice. Otherwise, you are still on the sand. And aren't you foolish? Aren't I foolish than the coins? Just coins, very feeble, having no much wisdom to go to classes, to go to schools. But they can manage to put the house well settled in the rocks. How about you? Who have got a lot of technology, a lot of intelligence, a lot of privileges of becoming a ruler of everything on earth. Couldn't we be the first to have a house in the rock? Just meditate. Father, we're going to the third. People, very weak, very despised, very wise. Verse 27, the Bible says, the locusts have no king, okay? They have got no king, right? Yet go they forth, all of them, by bands. They have got no president. They have got no ruler. They have got no leader. They have got no pastor. They have got no church elder. They have got no any controller or manager. But they go in bands. They go united. Oh, what an amazing thing! How about you and me? People who have got presidents, who have got rulers, who have got pastors, let's come in the church. The church is organized from the general conference down to the local church, trying to make us to be ordered people. But we find that after this all arrangement, we are still stubborn. We are still people with confusion in the church. People not agreeable, people without unity, and people with no peacemaking culture. Always we find problems to rise. But look at our friends, the locusts. We start tumults and confusions in the church whereby there's all the organizations, church elder, whatever, whatever. But still, we can't be united. We can't be organized. But look at the locusts. They're very well united people. is a lesson of God to us who are stubborn to be agreeable, to be ruled by the organization set by God. Let's come to the fourth one. The Bible says on verse 28, the spies take hold with her hands and is in king's palace. The spider is also a small insect. We cannot ask him, spider, how come thou hast preached in the house of the king? Someone to get in the house of the king should meet a lot of spirit guards up there, out there, in the gate, maybe 2, 3, 4 gates before you reach to the king. For example, in Africa, we have got some states which are controlled by the kings, like Eswatini, which was Swaziland, Lesotho. Those are some of the kingdoms, I mean, for now, which are located in Southern African side of the continent. To come to the king, it's not something easy. It's not something easy. You have to be asked questions. You have to be asked and explain the main reason which takes you to meet the king. And if your reasons be not reasonable, you can't be allowed to meet the king. But you may find a spider has come already in the house of the king. Now you wonder, spider, how did you come here? When you asked by the guards, did you pass through the gate? How comes you are inside already? You find has been somewhere in, on top or somewhere in the house of the king. But a person like me to come in, a lot of questions, even if not possible to fail. But the spider already has come and put his house in the top or somewhere else in the king's house, in the palace. And see how wise the spider. But we human beings, we fail to dwell in the house of the king. Why? We are fools. We are fools. We may not accept it, but we are fools. We are not small than the spoiler. We were given authority to control everyone. And in this, we could even have wisdom higher than any creature. And that is how God made us. But how come some of the animals, they have overtaken us? Because we are willing fools. We're just willing to be fools. We have got a palace on high, waiting for us to dwell. We should inquire the wisdom of a spider, make all other way, how to get in that kingdom, to make all strategies like how a spider does, until we get in that kingdom. This is wisdom needed now than ever before. It will be something so much amazing. Just imagine a human being like me. A human being like me from Mozambique, for example. Not me alone, but any other, but I just give example of me. Passing on, getting through the gates of the city in Jerusalem, opened by Jesus, the Master, the Creator of heaven and earth, and getting into the streets of gold, whereby the city is so much beautiful and great. I thank God that we are not going to take cameras to heaven, otherwise it could be full of pictures. We could take a lot of pictures because heaven is so much beautiful. On the golden streets, you could need to take some selfies, as now we know, some pictures. But it is not describable. The beauty of it is higher, greater than what we can explain. So just imagine a human being like me, I'm walking on the golden streets, of which gold today is expensive. Even getting it, even a small one, not even stepping on it, just a small one in the hand. You can get more money, a lot of money. But it to be like a soil of the land, to step on it. Now the father will wonder, the father, the ancient of days, will ask you, who are these? And Jesus will answer, these are they that I died for. These are they, those which I redeemed by my own blood. Wow! Which means we are getting inside because of Jesus. We'll be in the back of Jesus. Entering in the seat in the name of Jesus. That is the wisdom needed, like of the spire. Because it is not easy to get in the place where is for the angels, the great place for God, a sinful man like I, if in case there's no wisdom used. And that wisdom is to go in the city, but hiding in Jesus. And when the Father asks, Jesus is the one answer. And we will get in by keeping what the advocate tells us to do. Because he knows how to earth and defend us before the Father. So dear brothers and sisters, as we come to the close of this lesson, let each meditate. It will be sad after hearing at least last words of warning again to the lost. May the Lord be merciful to us, and may we be merciful to ourselves, so that one day we'll meet all in the kingdom of the Lord, rejoicing, getting happy for everlasting, everlasting, into the sanctuary of the everlasting, getting no more bored, no more disturbed, no more disappointed, no more heartbroken. This will be our rejoicing and our gift, our reward from the Master. This is what God wants us to live, not to live a miserable life we are living now on earth. Just see, people, they are fearing everywhere. Corona, 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 coronavirus. But there's no corona. There's no HIV AIDS. There's no anything in heaven. That is the life what God wants us to live. A pure happiness. A pure peace of mind in heaven. May the Lord help us as we prepare ourselves to meet Jesus Christ in the clouds. May God bless you all for your attention. Before we come to the close of our lesson, let us also close with the prayer. I will kneel down and have the final prayer. Our dear Father in heaven, thank you for the time you had given us to study of your word. Help us that whatever word you have spoken through your servant may bear fruits for everlasting life. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.